with new trends and changing markets, plus with car development and production being very expensive, car companies have built all sorts of cars over the years. From unknown brands building sport cars, to sport car makers building minivans, trucks, and even airplanes. People complain a lot nowadays about the SUVs. But it's thanks to these SUVs that Porsche, for example, managed to build the 911 the same way they have always done. And before the SUV craze, many companies were into minivans, which back in the 90s were extremely popular. And one of the names they decided to give this market a try was Porsche. Now, back in the 80s and 90s, Porsche was struggling a lot. And so, under commission, they built all sorts of things. From well-known projects like the amazing 500e to obscure projects like the 911 powered airplanes. But in the 90s, Porsche decided to enter the minivan market. This wasn't to be their first project of this type, since back in the 80s, Porsche had built the B32 based on the T3 of VW. But differently from the B32, the Varera was an experimental study, which could go into production. Developed in the late 90s, Varera was based on the first gen Charan, which was just launched a couple of years prior. The exterior wasn't that crazy, with only the front face and the rear end, which were designed to look more like quote-unquote Porsche. The interior on the other side received more changes, again to keep up with the Porsche tradition. And talking about Porsche traditions, the Varera was powered by the same 3.6 liter flat 6 as the 996. But in 98, Porsche introduced the Boxster, which definitely helped Porsche a lot. And also in 98, Mercedes introduced the next big thing, the M-Class, which changed the market forever and also the mind of Porsche about the SUVs. It's unknown what happened to Varera, but it's believed that the car was destroyed in the late 90s. But Porsche wasn't the first that gave minivan a try. In the late 80s and early 90s, both BMW and Lamborghini also experimented with the idea of a family mover. First was Lamborghini with the Genesis in 1988, a V12 455 horsepower Countach powered 5-seater. From the beginning, the Genesis was built as a show car, but Bertone went full on. Most of the time these projects are just clay models, but it's really amazing to see that a wild thing like this is fully functional. And a similar thing can be said also for BMW Columbus. Powered by a 5-liter BMW V12, the Columbus could seat 9, including the driver which sit on the center, F1 style. And like the Previa of Toyota, the Columbus was mid-engine, with the engine being underneath the driver's seat. While the Genesis was built for full performance, the Columbus was built with a luxury in mind. From the inside, the car looked more like a jet airplane than a luxury car. Full leather seats, TVs, VHA system, fax machine, and even a starlight ceiling. The Columbus was designed by Tal Design, which back in the early 90s was working close with BMW, designing cars like the Nazca C2 and the Nazca N12. But Ital Design was mostly specialized on car like Columbus. From the beginning, they said they set apart from the rest of the Italian coach builders by taking a piece of the market which the rest didn't care for. And in 2000, Ital Design would return again with a similar car like the Columbus, with the Buran of Maserati. After Fiat returned the Trident in Italy, they were working hard to bring Maserati back to its former glory. This by building cars like the 3200 and the new Quattroporte. At the same time, they were releasing a number of concepts, and one of these was the Buran, a very strange vehicle. Buran could seat 4, had sliding doors, but at the same time didn't have a hatchback, but a boot like a sedan. The Buran used the same engine as the 3200, which produced 370 horsepower, which might sound like a lot, but Buran wasn't a small car at all, since it measured at 5 meters in length and 2 meters in width. It's hard to say if Maserati ever considered to put the Buran into production, but they were trying different styles in the early 2000s, including here an SUV, which really was ahead of its time. So guys, thank you for watching and see you next time.